Hello friends, in the present video we will understand the concept of working capital management and introduction. This is the first video of working capital management, so we will understand only theoretical part of the working capital management. Down the line I am going to make further videos based on this, that is second and third related to problems. Once it is made, the link will be shared in I button as well as in the description box. Right, so we will understand what do you mean by the working capital management. So working capital management here is also one of the most important parts of the financial management. So this is the working capital management is a part of financial management. It concerned with the short-term finance of the business concern, which is closely related to trade between profitability and liquidity. So here our emphasis would be on profitability as well as liquidity. Efficient working capital management leads to improve the operating performance of business concern, and it helps to meet the short-term liquidity. So operating performance is very much associated with the working capital management, because unless and until you have proper management of working capital, it is highly difficult for you to run the operations of the business. Hence, the study of working capital management is not only an important part of financial management, but also overall management of the business concern. So working capital management is concerned with the many areas such as purchase of raw material, production, sale of goods, right, and creditors even. So all these areas are associated and connected with working capital. Hence, that's the reason why we call it as it is an overall management of business concern. Working capital is described as a difference between the book value of current assets and current liabilities. Down the line in the further slides, we'll understand gross and net working capital. There I will understand. There I will explain you the crux of the current assets and current liabilities. Meaning of working capital. When you talk about the meaning of working capital, working capital is further divided into two categories. One is fixed capital. What do you mean by fixed capital? It refers to the long-term investment of the business concern. In the sense what? Amount applied, the capital amount applied on purchase of fixed assets are permanent assets called as fixed capital, which is of the nature of non-recurring in the nature. Again and again, it will not incur. Whereas working capital is another part of capital which is needed for meeting, this is the very important, meeting day-to-day requirements of the business concern. Because unless and until we meet day-to-day requirement, it is highly difficult for us to run the show of business. So for example, of the working capital are payment to creditors, salary paid to worker, purchase of raw material, etc. And normally it consists of recurring in the nature. These expenditures are recurring in the nature. In the sense, again and again we incur. It can be easily converted into cash in the sense for payment of creditors or collection from debtors in both the ways. Hence, it is also known as short-term capital. Definitions. When you talk about definitions, I have written here some of the definitions are well-known definitions. When you see all the definitions, right? So first definition, working capital means current assets. The sum of current assets is the working capital of the business. Working capital refers to the firm's investment in short-term assets such as cash, short-term securities, accounts receivable, and inventories. Again, these are the elements of working capital. The working capital is the amount of funds necessary to cover the cost of operating enterprise. So whatever it may be, all these definitions, if you see, collectively it comes to a meaning that the current assets are the very, very important ingredient and part of the working capital. In the sense, working capital is majorly refers to as current assets. Concept of working capital. Here there are two concepts of working capital. One is gross working capital. What do you mean by gross working capital? Gross working capital is refers to the summation of current assets. All the current assets collectively called as gross working capital. Whereas net working capital here refers to the excess of current asset over the current liabilities. The objective, the logic here is always business wanted to maintain the current asset double or twice the current liability so that whatever amount collected through current assets will be used for making the payment of current liabilities. Therefore, the excess of current assets over the current liabilities is called as net working capital here. Right, components of working capital, as we have already discussed, that is current assets and current liabilities. These are the current assets, these are the current liabilities. Some of the examples of current assets: cash in and cash at bank, bills receivable, sundry debtors, short term loans and advances, inventories, prepaid expenses, accrued income or outstanding income. Like current liabilities, we have bills payable, sundry debtors, outstanding expenses, any short term loans and advances which we have received, dividend payable, bank overdraft, or provision for tax. So these are the current assets and current liabilities. All right. Thank you very much for watching the video. Please do subscribe my channel, Mentor the Trusted Guide. So in the next video, we will understand the estimation of working capital requirement and problems to solve, how to solve the problems of estimation of working capital. Thank you very much for being patient listeners. Do subscribe my channel and motivate me to make more qualitative videos. Thank you.